Okay, today we are going to see some more problems which are different on the concept triangle. Already we have seen criteria, we have seen the theorem for ASA. Okay, now see here, today's first problem is L and M are two parallel lines intersected by another pair of parallel lines P and Q as shown in figure. Show that triangle ABC and triangle CDA are congruent. Okay. So here what they have told us, L and M are two parallel lines. Here figure is given, L and M are two parallel lines. Also P and Q, this is also pair of parallel lines, are intersected. Okay, intersected by another pair of parallel lines P and Q as shown in figure. Show that triangle ABC congruent triangle CDA, means ABC and CDA. We have to show this triangle and this triangle congruent. Okay. So here we know that when lines are parallel and it cut by a transversal, that time alternate interior angles are always equal. Okay, so see here, L and M are parallel lines, L and M are parallel lines, okay. P and Q also parallel lines and intersected to both this L and M. Also AC is also a transversal, AC is also transversal, understood. So here AC is transversal, so angle 3 and angle 2 are equal, okay, and angle 4 and angle 1 are equal. Okay, what is the reason? Alternate interior angles. Okay, when lines are parallel, it cut by a transversal. Here AC is a transversal, so we can say angle 3 and angle 2 are equal, angle 4 and angle 1 are equal. So here first, what is given? L is parallel to M, and what is given? E is parallel to Q. This is given. Okay. So AC is a transversal. AC is a transversal. So we can say angle 3 is equal to angle 2. Angle 3 and angle 2 are equal. Alternate interior angle. This is we will say first. Then angle 4 is equal to angle 1. Or angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Anyhow. So this is second one. So what is the reason? What is the reason? Alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles. Okay. So now we will use both the triangles. So here we can see here angle 3 is equal to angle 2, angle 1 is equal to angle 4, and AC is common for both the triangles. So by ASA, angle side angle, we can say both the triangles are congruent. Okay, so we need to bring on the paper in the proper way. So now we can say in triangle ABC and triangle CDA, okay, we have three things. What is that? First one, angle 3 is equal to angle 2. Okay, so what is the reason? From 1, here we have given reason. So from 1 we can write, that is enough. Then AC is the common side for both the triangles. AC is equal to AC. What is the reason? Common. Okay. And last one, angle 4. Angle 4 is equal to angle 1. So this is from second. From second. Okay. Second is here. So from second, angle, side, angle. So we can say triangle ABC, congruent triangle CDA by ASA, angle side angle. By ASA, both the triangles are congruent. Okay. So see here, only the thing is that included side, we need to think about two angles and included side. So angle, side and angle. Okay. So this is the explanation, and this problem is from NCERT book. Okay. Okay, see here our second problem is, in figure, if AB is parallel to DC and P is the midpoint of BD, prove that P is also the midpoint of AC. P is also the midpoint of AC. Okay, so here what is given? See, two triangles are given and P is the midpoint of DP, they have told us, and here it is given. Means here what is given? DP is equal to BP, that is given. Okay, so first I am taking here whatever given things are there. DP is equal to BP. This is given. Okay, Now what they have told us, CD and AB are parallel. CD parallel to AB. CD parallel to AB. Okay. If CD is parallel to AB, that time DB and CA are the transversal. Are the transversal. Okay. So here what we can say, CDP, CDP means this angle. CDP is equals to PBA, this angle. Okay, why? What is the reason? Alternate interior angles. Okay, second thing, DCP is equals to PAP, this angle is also equal to this angle. And side is given DP is equals to PB. But in this condition, we cannot use ASA criteria because we have two angles and one side. We have two angles and one side which are equal to the two angles and one side. But this side is not included by the two angles. Okay, so here we cannot use ASA criteria. Understood? So if I want to use ASA criteria, two angles and included side should be there. Okay, which is equal to the two angles and included side of corresponding triangle. Okay, so here this angle and this angle is alternate interior angle. Side is given DP is equals to BP. Now I want one more angle, so I can say this angle, angle DPC is equals to APC by vertically opposite angle. Okay, if I will use, I will go like that, then only I can say by angle side angle ASA criteria both the triangles are congruent. Okay, so now accordingly we will write here. So given DP is equal to, this is parallel line. So now to prove, what we have to prove? We have to prove that P is the midpoint of CA. So we have to prove AP is equals to CP. AP is equals to CP. This we have to prove. Okay. If we know what we are going to show, what we need to show, what is the question, then only we can plan our solution. Okay. So accordingly now we are going to take in triangle. In triangle DPC, DPC and triangle BPA, BPA. Okay, what we will say first, angle DPC, angle DPC is equals to angle BPA, angle BPA. Why? Vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles are always equal. So DPC, DPC, DPC is equals to BPA. These two angles are equal. Now we will think about side. DP is equals to BP. Second thing, DP is equals to BP. Okay. What is the reason? This is given. Okay. So this we will say second one. This is first one. Okay. Now what we will say? Angle over this angle over side over and now this. CDP angle CDP is equals to CDP is equals to ABP angle ABP. Okay, CDP means this and this angle are equal. What is the reason? This this alternate interior angles. Okay, alternate interior angles are equal. Why? Because CD and AB are parallel. Okay, so this is angle, side and angle. So by ASA criteria we can say triangle DPC congruent triangle BPA, DPC congruent BPA. Okay, by ASA criteria, angle, side, angle. Okay, now both the triangles are congruent means we can say CP is equals to AP by CPCD. Now we can say CP is equals to AP by CPCD, corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Okay, so now that was only question, AP is equal to CP, which they have told us, prove that P is also the midpoint of AC. P is midpoint means what? CP is equals to AP. Okay, so that we have shown here. Okay, see here, our third problem is, in figure, angle BCD is equal to angle ADC, angle BCD is equal to angle ADC, means this angle, angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Okay. Second, what is given? Angle ACB, angle ACB means angle 3 is equal to angle BDA, means angle 3 and angle 4 are equal. Okay. Prove that AD is equal to BC. Prove that AD is equal to BC and angle A is equal to angle B. Angle A and angle B are equal. Okay, very simple. Now here also, if we are able to prove both the triangles are congruent, means which two triangles ADC and triangle BCD, if both the triangles are congruent, then we can say by CPCT we can say this AD is equal to BC and angle A is equal to B. So here what is important? We have to show angle two triangles are congruent by using a perfect condition of congruence. Okay. So now we will think first what we need to do actually, and then we will bring on the paper. Okay. So see here what is given? If I am thinking about triangle ADC and triangle BCD, one thing I have, that is CD is common. CD is common. Okay. Second thing, what we can do here? Angle 3, angle 1, suppose I will use, but 1 is not a completely angle C. Okay. If I want to show angle C and angle D are equal, what I need to do? See, angle 3 and angle 4 are equal, angle 1 and angle 2 are equal. That means angle 1 plus 3 is equal to angle 2 plus 4. Angle 1 plus 3 is equal to angle 2 plus 4. So that one angle we got. Okay. So this whole angle, angle C, CD, angle C is equal to angle D. Okay. When you do sum that time, angle C is equal to angle D. Then we can say CD is common. Okay. For both the triangles. Then I can say angle 1 of this triangle or angle 2 is equal to angle 1. Okay, so by ASA criteria, we can show both the triangles are congruent. If triangles are congruent, these things AD is equal to BC and angle A is equal to angle B by CPCT, we can say. So see here, so now I'm thinking in solution, what we will do first, what is given? Angle BCD is equal to angle ADC, angle BCD means angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Angle 1 is equal to angle 2. This is given. As well as angle 3 is equal to angle 4. That is also given. Okay. From these two, I can say angle 1 plus angle 3. Angle 1 plus angle 3 is equal to angle 2 plus angle 4. Okay. So this is first, this is second, and from 1 and or from first and second, we can say sum of these two is equal to sum of these two. Okay. Finally, it is going to remain same. So here I can say angle ACD. What is angle 1 plus 3 is what? Angle ACD. Angle ACD is equal to 2 plus 4 is what? BDC. Angle BDC. Okay. So this is, I am saying this is third. Okay. Sum of these two is angle ACD. This. And this two is this. Okay. Now we will think about both the triangles. So triangle ADC and triangle ADC BCD. Okay. So first thing, this is ACD. Whatever we have, that is angle we are going to show. So that I am taking first. Angle ACD is equal to angle BDC. That is from third, okay, or third one directly we can take here. Okay, so this angle we have, this angle is equal to this angle. Then CD is common for both the triangles, so CD is equal to CD, that is common, okay, for both the triangles. Now I can see here, see ADC in that this angle, okay, and BCD is equal to this angle, means 2 and 1 are equal, which is given. So I can say here BDC angle, BDC, B BDC, oh sorry, BDC not, angle ADC, ADC, we are thinking only this angle, ADC is equals to BCD angle, BCD, okay, why, which is given, given angle 1 is equals to angle 2, that is given in the question. So from this 3, we can say triangle ABC, congruent triangle BCD by angle, side angle. So by ASA. Okay, by ASA, two triangles are congruent. If triangles are congruent, now we can say which they are asking AD is equals to BC and angle A is equals to angle B. Okay, AD is which side? See, AD and BC. BC. Okay, because these two sides are the corresponding sides of congruent triangle. Okay, and angle A and angle B are also corresponding triangles, and we have given here two triangles are congruent. So by CPCT we can give here reason CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Okay, so this is important. First we need to show triangles are congruent. If triangles are congruent, then these things we can write within a statement. Okay, thank you.